Hey y'all, this is Sadies, and I'm just here because you know Gerald, he always over the top, and he wants to do a little tribute to our relationship, so I hope y'all enjoy.
Hey, what's happening, y'all? Look, y'all tuning in with the vision, man. Let me tell y'all a little something about the love of my life, Sadie, man. Y'all stay tuned, please, hit it.
Cliches in the dark past.
Yeah, what's that about?
One of the good bows.
I'm gonna get them right. Hell, I need a good bow. Shit, I need a good bow too, hell.
Me too again.
Yeah.
This is a tribute to her and our relationship over these last 4 years. So y'all stay tuned, y'all sit back and check this out.
How we met, we met at a party, man. Her mom, her and her mom, a couple of their friends, they came to some of my people house for a little get together. I was coming in off the road, so they called me and told me to come straight home. You know, I didn't know what for, but you know, I was like, all right, man, I'm coming. So when I got home, they gave me the rundown and told me who she was. We met at a party and it just went from there.
Well, backstory.
She had eyes on
me. I initially went to a dinner party before the get-together. I went with my mom, but it was all her friends. And my mom had this thing all the time. Y'all got somebody for my daughter? She always say that. I'm like, Mom, please stop. Well, it was a gentleman at the end of the table said, hey, I got somebody for you. Come to the house afterwards, and you can meet my nephew. I was like, I mean, I ain't got nothing to lose. I mean, I'm single. Why not? So I'm like, okay, cool. And so I went to the party, and that's how we met.
Yeah, she heard about the bishop, man, and you know, who's this bishop?
No, I didn't think none of that.
Yeah. Who's this bishop?
He came in that house with a bad baby, and I was just like, woo, hard working man.
It was trying times in the kingdom. All right, I'm gonna tell you what's going on. Listen. So I had to bring some of that Alabama flavor to Jamaica. You know what I'm saying? They wanted to copy some of the Bishop music. So they said, Bishop, you can hear about this.
For me, it was my mom because she was at the party with me. I kind of felt like it was something, it was different. It was different in a good way. So I was, you know, even though he swore to God I gave him the runaround, oh, I did not.
Can we talk about that?
No, because I didn't. But I knew, I hoped that we could take it, you know, take it somewhere, because I didn't like it. But he swore to God.
It's going to be all in here. We're going to get to the question in a minute. Yeah, she did get it. She gave me the runaround for a good one. The first day we were supposed to be like actually sit down and talk about it. I invited her to ride with me on the trip. You know what I'm saying? Like, look, let's go do a run and sit down and talk. Man, I was gonna text and call this joke 12 hours.
Not done that shit true.
12 hours and 30 minutes, I get a text back. Oh, I'm hungover. I was this, I was
that. I mean,
that.
I was.
So I'm gonna put it to you like this. For the first maybe 8 months, we played cat and mouse with each other. We would talk for a little while, we'll stop talking because, and then we'll start talking because of, and then we'll stop talking, and then I'll stop talking to her, she'll find a way to start that talking to me. So it was cat and mouse for a little while. But the first person I told was Dean and Kim. They were the one that orchestrated. Yeah, it was, shout out to them. The real reason for the second season. She finally turned them lips loose, man. You know, she kept seeing these big red things. And, seeing her eyes start to get red. Fall into my arms, baby. But she fell into my arms like later down like this, you know what I'm saying? And I locked in on her. I locked in on like a fat vice grip, man. Yes, I did. Mean.
Yeah, that's
a
good one.
Oh, man. I think we got our own different views on it, but you know. Oh, man.
Okay. Gerald fart a lot in his sleep, but they be, but they be like pop, 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 like my, I know he gonna say me, because I got to a point where I never, ever thought I would fart in front of a man, ever. This is the most comfortable. I'm so comfortable. I don't think that I'm just gonna say me, because you don't fart around me. You fart in his sleep. I just catch him, like, you know, in his sleep. But it's me. I blame it.
Yeah, let me tell you something, man. She be blowing it down. She be giving it all she got. You hear me? And she like to do it with my damn mouth open. I'm talking about, man.
Look, mama told me it's better out the end. So
let me tell you something. I just remember this one day, man, and I was laying in the bed and she ended up going to the bathroom. All I heard was POM! Oh! I feel way to the end. All I heard was POM! Oh! What on there? Yeah, she told me, man. But I love it though. I love it. Because it's real, it's authentic, and Lord knows it's changed.
I wonder what you be saying about me when I'm not around.
My team, well, let's get into it. Roll it, my boy.
The first thing she said to me that stuck with me the first night we met was, she said that, "I think that I'll be good for you." Up until now, I kind of always kept that near and dear to me. I kept it in the back of my head that I met somebody that said that they think that they'll be good for me. Certain things people say you don't take for granted. You know, you made me more of a patient person. You definitely changed my life for the better. Even though I was where I was in life, you showed me that it was more room to improve. You introduced me to parenthood. So now you introduced me to fatherhood. You held me to everything I said I was. Everything that I've always preached to you that I am, you held me accountable for that. A king is only as good as his queen pushes him to be. Even when I was wanting to throw in the towel and was telling you I was gonna leave and walk away, it was just something about things you say that would make me drive myself to understand more. I don't know if you remember that, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if you remember when you told me that you would be good for me, but I don't have a doubt in my mind now. You know, back then it was questionable, but now I'm for sure that, you know, you pretty much the piece to the puzzle. You is everything I needed.
My favorite memory with Gerald is this recent summer. Again, we haven't been able to go on vacation, but we finally got to go on vacation to Cancun. And we had an Airbnb with a lot of new friends. And we decided to play hide and go seek in the dark in a big old mansion in Cancun, which, don't knock it. I know we old, but it was fun. And Gerald decided to hide his big ass in the closet. I have a picture if y'all wanna see. And I think we laughed hard because he thought I was gonna help him find me, and I wasn't. But I found him, and he was hiding in the closet with another guy. And they were stuffed in the closet. sweating. Yeah, it was funny. Yeah, that, I think that we had fun. I think we let loose because we needed to. All we do is laugh. But one of the funniest moments I have is when we went to Vegas and we went to this place called the Heart Attack Burger, I think it's called. And you, if you don't eat all your food, you get whooped with a paddle. And his big old son got up there. He didn't eat all his food. And it was a little small girl, but she had a hand on her and she cocked back and she popped his ass hard. And all he did was, he was screaming and he had everybody outside standing out there looking at him. As big as he is, and he was hollering the way he was hollering because he was getting popped by a little 4-foot girl. That was a good memory. It was funny and I got it all on video if anybody wanna see.
Back in the day, we was cool.
You gonna say anything?
I don't know.
Oh,
shit. I
just got
the beat.
Oh, we got us lit, folks. My favorite song that remind me of her, it'll definitely be Gucci Mane and Monica, We Ride. That song describes how I feel about her and our relationship as one.
I hope I got the name of the song right, but it's On the Road.
On the Run.
On the Run. See, On the Run, Beyonce and Jay-Z. That's, every time I hear it, it explains the authentic love they ride together. Like, I'm the body to his Clyde. Like, yeah, if he going, I'm going. It's vice versa. So,
we ain't lose the draw, man. Yeah, we here. Right, wrong, indifferent.
Yep.
We here.
All that I want to accomplish with y'all is finally get my Rico. Okay. But I know it's coming. I am not rushing him. I'm not in a rush. I have no doubt that it's not going to happen. But yeah, I'm going to need that ring soon, sir. But yeah, I love him. And I can't wait to walk on the aisle with him. That's my goal.
So what's next for y'all?
So the next thing. Give it up.